evening, everybody. Welcome to your terrific Tuesday Turning Point for Tuesday, August the 2nd, 2022. Can you believe tomorrow's going to be episode 800 for my morning devos? Wow. Today is episode 306 or 307. I'm not quite sure. The number will be in the title, so the correct number will be there. So. But in this one, we're going to be learning about a faithful king, beginning with 1 Corinthians 4:17, which we'll be reading in the recommended reading, 1 Corinthians 4:14 to 21. There is a footnote at the end of the first section, a little first paragraph. Our turning point today is from Dallas A. Brauninger, B-R-A-U-N-I-N-G-E-R. And our Bible reading, we're finishing up the book of Isaiah, Isaiah 64, 65, and 66. The last three chapters of the book of Isaiah. So if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Comment, how was your day today? How did today go? Did anything surprising happen on the second day of August? Let me know. Well, a faithful king. 1 Corinthians, well, let's just go ahead and read. 1 Corinthians 4, 14 to 21. Open right to it. 14 to 21. I do not write these things to shame you, but as my beloved children, I warned you. For though you might have 10,000 instructors in Christ, yet you do not have many fathers, for in Christ Jesus I have begotten you through the gospel. Therefore I urge you, imitate me. For this reason I have sent Timothy to you, who is my beloved and faithful son in the Lord, who will remind you of my ways in Christ, as I teach everywhere in every church. Now some are puffed up as though I were not coming to you, but I will come to you shortly, if the Lord wills, and will know not the word of those who are puffed up, but the power. For the kingdom of God is not in word, but in power. What do you want? Shall I come to you with a rod, or in love and a spirit of gentleness? So it says, for this reason I have sent Timothy to you, on 17, who is my beloved and faithful son in the Lord, who will remind you of my ways in Christ. So earlier this year, a hiker died of apparently natural causes in the obscure spot in Griffith Park in Los Angeles. When his remains were found 2 weeks later, his faithful dog King, we're not talking about a king, we're talking about King, the dog, was still standing guard over his master. King, who was a golden retriever, was hungry and emaciated, but he had done his duty. And that was an excerpt from The Body of a Missing Man Found in Griffith Park with His Dog by His Side, from ABC7, which is a news outlet, April the 2nd, 2022. Man, that just happened in April. Wow. That just happened. Back at the end of March, 1st of April. Wow. Usually when I read those footnotes, I have last year, the year before, 19, be an older date, but when it's just happened a few months ago, it shocks me. So the Bible often tells us we can learn things from animals. The hard-working ant, the soaring eagle, the panting deer, the dependent lamb. We can also learn a lesson from King. Sometimes trouble beset us and grief dismays us, but we can always be faithful. Timothy was faithful to Paul in all circumstances, even as Paul was faithful to Christ, and Christ was faithful to them both. Faithfulness provided the trust that bound all things together with the cords of stability and strength. So it may be no more than standing beside someone in need, but faithlessness here on earth will receive heaven's badge of honor. Amen? So Dallas A. Brauninger, Brauninger, he says the level of trust requisite to a fruitful working partnership with a dog guide is analogous to a genuine relationship with a generative God. Neither is easy, yet both are simple. Okay. So that's all I have for today. Coming up tomorrow in either episode 307 or 308, we're going to be talking about the forgotten word. Wait a minute. Tomorrow is episode 800 for my daily Devo videos. So we're going to be talking about, first part, we're going to be talking about Paul's missionary journey, beginning with Ephesians 3:8 from Henry M. Morse, and then When Prayer Shakes the Earth from James Banks, derived from Revelation 8:1-6. That will be both passages together in one episode, in one video, or maybe live video, hopefully. Or it'll be turned around and recorded day of, pre-recorded video, but it'll still be turned around, recorded, and loaded and edited. But it'll all be in one video. So, but your episode tomorrow night will be The Forgotten Word, beginning with Psalm 4:7, which will be reading the Psalm chapter 4, the whole Psalm 4 in the recommended reading. Our turning point is from William L. Thompson, and Jeremiah 1-3 is the Bible reading. So, end up Isaiah today and start on Jeremiah tomorrow. So, with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell, come back later. Come back tomorrow for more, including episode 800, which should be live, or if the live don't work, they'll turn around and be recorded. Recorded, edited, and posted. All in the same. And it will be afternoon when those videos come out. So stay tuned. I'll hopefully see you in the live. Hopefully, if the live stream works, I'll see you in the live one, or you'll see me in the recorded one. And it'll turn around and be recorded. So, until then, God bless everyone, and I'll see you tomorrow. Ha ha. Goodbye.